Hello, welcome back to the Flanagan Homestead. Tonight I was going to do chainsaw basics, but this video is going to be about nothing but gas and mixing the gas properly and how important that is. Just in case you didn't know how important that is or how important mixed gas alone is, I have a quick story. As an elder of our church, we were going to go help do a service project cleaning up a city park. It had a lot of blackberries growing in it and weeds growing up, so we brought a bunch of weed whackers, different people from the church. I was told by a couple people that, this is mixed gas, go ahead and use it. So we put it in my weed whacker, we put it in my dad's, we put it in John's, and pretty soon my weed whacker comes back and the kids are like, "I don't know what's going on, Dad. I can't even pull the pull cord." And I was like, "What's going on?" And so I'm looking at it, and I thought maybe the pull cord was just messed up. And then someone else comes back with John's weed whacker and says, "I can't pull the cord." And anyway, they've seized up both motors. I said, "Where'd you get the gas?" They showed me, I checked it. It was not mixed gas, big mistake. And I thought someone had put that same gas in my dad's weed whacker, so I'm running across the park, "Stop, don't turn the motor on." Anyway, we emptied out the gas, we saved my dad's. John and I both had to buy new machines. Mine was old enough that they're like, "You don't want to put the money into fixing it, just get a new one." So that was fine with me. I got a bigger and better one. But at the time when, that's what lubricates the motor, is the oil inside the gas. So if you don't do that, you're going to seize up your motor. When I bought my new professional grade, bigger and better weed whacker, my friends down at the steel shop said, "You absolutely have to use the synthetic oil in your mix. And as a matter of fact, it's better for all of your tools." And I have thousands of dollars of equipment from them. So this is the only stuff I use now. It comes in the gray or the silver at the steel shop instead of the orange. Okay. The other thing is, it's really important to keep fresh gas, especially now that most gases have ethanol in it. The ethanol, moist water can separate, do some bad things to your motor there over time. You want to use that within a month if you have ethanol gas. You can, and it's preferred, to get a non-ethanol gas. And if you go to puregas.org, it's a website, it tells you which gas stations will have non-ethanol gas, which is recommended for these. If you look at it on the Steel website and the Husqvarna website, they will tell you that they recommend non-ethanol gas. If you do get ethanol gas, you want to use it up quickly. Also, the ethanol is a solvent, and it can do damage to your carburetors over time too. So if you can get non-ethanol gas, do it. If not, the higher the octane, the better. That's what they recommended at the steel shop there. So even though I have a Christmas tree farm and we'll be running saws all day long during harvest season, I mix up 1 gallon containers. I may mix up multiple pull of them so that we can have our saws running all day, but then we try to run it out. And the reason I do this, and you know, there's all kinds of complicated ways of measuring things out and whatnot, but number one, you just buy these. I know it's a little bit more expensive, but not that much. Just buy these. This is a mix for 1 gallon. You buy a 1 gallon gas tank. There's a line right here where it says 1 gallon. You fill it up halfway full, dump the entire contents in. I don't need to show you how to do it. It's not rocket science. Fill it up the rest of the way, make sure it's shaking good, and you've got a precise mix. And as they said, if you're someone that doesn't use a whole lot of gas, you don't want to have a 5 gallon mix tank sitting around for months and months and months. You want to keep your gas fresh. So even though we will be running saws for hours and hours on a given day, we are mixing it up in 1 gallon tanks, and then we will run them all day. And if we run out one tank, we'll start using the next one. We'll fill this up the next day with fresh gas, and the gas that we're running is really clean and fresh. Just remember, it's really important to use good gas and properly mix it to keep the longevity of your equipment going. I hope you enjoyed this here on the Flanagan Homestead today, where Christmas trees are my business, teaching including horticulture is my job, and outdoor projects are my passion. Hope to see you again.